Hello and welcome back to Amulya's Academy YouTube channel. We were discussing hash tables. Today, let's write Python program to implement a hash table using basic concepts. Here, we will use a list to represent the hash table, and this program uses chaining to handle collusion. Alright, let's write the program. In a Python file, first take a variable and assign the value 10 to it. Here we'll take hash table size as 10. Done. Next, let's create an empty hash table using list. Here we'll use list comprehension method. It is a variable. And here number of elements in the list is depend on the table size. So if I print this hash table now, save and execute. Initially, empty hash table will look like this. Next. A common step in all hash table operations is finding the index. So let's define a function for that. Just remove this. Let's take this function name as hashing. Here we'll find the index. So we need key. To find the index, we need key. Then this function will return hash key modulus. So this is the formula to find the index, and here hash key. So this will find the hash value, hash code. Then we'll apply modulus operation on this table size and hash code, and we'll find the index. Here we'll use hash function to get hash value. In Python, hash function doesn't simply add up the ASCII codes of characters. Instead, it uses a much more complex and efficient algorithm. And also, this hash function can give different values across runs of the same program for the same input. We'll talk about that later. This is the Python built-in function, hash function. We are using this function to find the hash value. Done. So we are done with this function. Next, let's define the function for hash table operations. First, for insert operation, define. Let's take function name as insert. To perform insertion operation, we need key and value. Let's take two parameters, key and value. And the first step in insertion operation is to find the index. So for that, let's call this hashing function. We'll store that return result in this index variable. Next, let's check if key is already exists. This function works for both insert and update operation. If key is already present, then update its value. If key is not present, then insert the key value pair. There can be multiple key value pairs in a single bucket. To check for the given key, we need to check key value pairs in the bucket one by one. So for that, we'll use for loop. As I said, a bucket can contain multiple key value pairs because of collusion. And here we are using chaining method to handle the collusion. So we can find multiple key value pairs in a single bucket. We need to go through every key value pair and we need to find the key, right? So for that, we are using this statement. We'll use for loop for item in hash table of index. We'll get the index using this function, hashing function. We'll go through every item or key value pair in that bucket, in that index. Like this here, you can see the representation. Item represent a list. And the first element will be key and the second element will be value. So we'll check item of 0 is equal to key. We'll compare the given key with the first element of that list. And if both are same, then we'll update its value. If it is true, that means key is already exists. So we need to update value like this and return. After updating the value, no need to execute the next lines. So stop. If key is not found or bucket is empty, then append new key value pair. So hash table index dot append key value pair. It is a list. Append this list. Okay, now we are done. In the insert operation, first we'll check whether our key is already present in the hash table or not. If key is already present, then update the value. If key is not present, then append that key value pair, that list of key value pair to the hash table. Simple, right? Next, let's display the hash table. For that, let's write a function like this. Function name is display. And here let's use for loop. We want to print every item, print item. Okay, next let's call these functions. First let's print an empty hash table. So let's call display. Next let's insert few key value pairs, right? Next later let's call display function again. Let's save and execute. Here you can see the list, but let me add a sentence here. After insertion you can see the hash table like this. If you want, you can print the index also. For that you need to use enumerate function here. Built-in function, it allows you to print index and value. And for that let's take I like this, and here now save and execute. And here you can see this is the bucket 0, bucket 1, bucket 2, bucket 3, like this. After insertion you can see key value pairs. And if you observe this output carefully, then you'll see a difference. That is, here now you can see in bucket 0, A and apple. In bucket 1, C and cat. In bucket 2, B and cat. Right. Then I'll close this. I'll again save this and run this. And now here you can see in bucket 1, B and bat. In bucket 2, A and apple. And in bucket 3, C and cat. That's because of this hash function, okay? This hash function gives you different result for different runs. Okay, next we need to define functions for delete and search operations, which we will cover in the next tutorial. So that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.